an example of a cut-off Aqualung that was not all Sturm and Drang and heaviness and riffs. The song is called Mother Goose, originally released on Aqualung. This version from a 1999 recording in Seattle for a small audience and one of the first satellite radio broadcasts. Mother Goose from 1999 gives the band a chance to sort of flex their chops, and as a critic said when this album was released, Mother Goose cleans up rather well.
I'd walk by Amsterdam, I came upon Mother Goose, so I turned her loose. She was screaming, and a foreign student said to me, was it really true? There are elephants and lions too in Piccadilly Circus. Down by the bathing pond to try and catch some sun. Must have been 100 schoolgirls sobbing into handkerchiefs as one. I don't believe they knew I was a schoolboy. A bearded lady said to me, if you start your raving and you're misbehaving, you'll be sorry. And a chicken fancier came to play with his long red beard and his sister's weird. She drives a lorry. Down by the putting green, I pop them in their holes. 4 and 20 laborers were laboring, digging up their holes. I don't believe they knew that I was Long John Silver. watch Honey Scarecrow make his rounds with his jetpack, which he won't give back, stole it from a snowman. As I did walk by Hampstead Fair, I came upon Mother Goose, so I turned her loose. She was screaming, oh.
I always liked that song, Mother Goose. Just a little weird set of vignettes. And, you know, it was from a whole other world. I was a suburban kid from California, and here was this music that was all kind of mossy and medievalish, you know, and this guy with the flute and all. I never saw them back in the day. But, you know, Jethro Tull was one of those kind of early 70s bands that was almost like a cliche, you know, that kids liked. I don't know. They were kind of not hip, but whatever the hell was hip where I was. You know what I mean? Make the case for Jethro Tull, basically, is what I'm asking you.
Well, David, it's true. Jethro Tull evokes Spinal Tap-ish imagery, exploding drummers, complicated sets, Stonehenge falling down, guys who want to be hobbits when they grow up. But the real Jethro Tull is something altogether different. The beating heart of Jethro Tull is Ian Anderson, as a singer-songwriter, a real traditional classic singer-songwriter who he writes what he sees and his fans see what he writes, comparable to guys like Lou Reed, Neil Young, Elvis Costello, and even in his own way, Bob Dylan. One of my friends is a kind of noted Nashville Dylanologist. His name is George Gomez. And he came with me to see Jethro Tull a couple years ago, and he was blown away. Like, hey, how come nobody told me about this guy and his songs? So I will make the case. The next three songs are kind of a sampler of Ian Anderson as singer-songwriter. A little bit of folk music, a little bit of rock and roll, a little bit of Scottish country, and a lot of poetry.
Yeah, like that. I mean, before we go into this set of three songs here, I just want to talk a little more about this. Because I recognize the quality of the songwriting immediately. And there's something about, one of the things that makes me love a performing artist or a recording artist is, you know, that they create a universe, like a unique world. And that one, it's definitely, you know, that's a unique voice. And that's a guy who's depicting a world not like my own, you know what I mean? I don't care about the hobbits and all that crap. I just heard really good songwriting and this awesome flute playing. You know, do you ever see the Isle of Wight film?
I have. That's when they were in their sort of young, wild, manic prime, getting a lot of attention. And that's when they got lumped in with early 70s bands, the way you described it. But since then, he's evolved, and he's really one of these guys who writes about what he knows. He's an Englishman who writes about the English countryside, his experiences traveling around the world. He's not pretending he's waiting for the midnight train in Georgia or something like that. Like, you know, Led Zeppelin sang and wrote a lot of Southern soul and blues that they picked up secondhand. This guy, yeah. This guy is painting the picture of what he sees.
Yeah, that's kind of a peeve of mine, actually, is people singing songs about still houses and hollers and stuff, you know, who've never been out of the suburbs. So, yeah, but there's also this thing. The song in the Isle of Wight thing that just knocked me out was this extended version of My God with this kick-ass flute solo in it. But the song itself, you know, there's a relationship, a discussion of, and maybe some conflict with, religion in a lot of this kind of music. And in fact, that makes me want to go back and ask you about the title Aqualung. It seems almost kind of a little too on the nose, you know, a consumptive, a guy with wet lungs, right? Is that what it is?
It is. The close-up, rasping breathing of the guys waiting in line for a handout at the Salvation Army mission in London.